In my career, I've never met a single person with his passion, ever. And there's not even a close second.
I get bloody. I put my body into the capture of the hunt.
The guy will go anywhere, climb any mountain to catch a fish in a stream. He's doing basically the work of a biologist just as sort of a volunteer.
Science is important because it's going to help us protect more populations of these fish that are somewhere only in one creek, somewhere in one river. It may be just another trout, but it's a special trout, and they're all special to me.
Steve MacMillan, what's the first impression you get when you meet him?
Nice.
That looks like a perky there.
Yeah, it does. It's almost difficult to understand him on the phone because he's so excited about fish, and he talks so fast. The one word to sum up Steve is passion.
I work in the big city, work long hours. I take a lot of work home with me. I have a lot of stress at work. But on weekends, I find myself in these hills, walking long mountain trails to go up there and try and catch a fish. I feel like I own the place, and many times I do own the place.
About 4 or 5 years ago was the Nevada Native Slam Program, a challenge to anglers in Nevada to catch every native species that includes Lahontan cutthroat, the Bonneville cutthroat, Yellowstone cutthroat, red band, bull trout, and mountain whitefish.
So I began trekking the state to catch these six species.
It's not easy. You need to travel great lengths to catch some of these species of fish, and they're in extremely remote, rugged locations. Well, Steve did it in 2.5 months.
For me to be the first to achieve it, it was very humbling. The last fish was probably, for most people, the easiest one to catch, but for me, I drove almost 3,000 miles over 5 trips to catch it, and when I caught that thing, it was like winning the Super Bowl. For me, it's basically finding that spot, knowing they're there, watching and observing instead of just being in a rush. I practice a technique I've named CPR, capture, photograph, release. Here we go. And got a good shot for posterity.
He documents everything that happens that day, and he gets stream temperature, air temperature, lengths and weights of fish, and pictures of that, and he'll prepare a report and send it to us. He'll be out at a stream that we haven't been to in 50, 60 years, and he'll grab fin clips for us. And that fin sample is used for genetic analysis to determine if, you know, if that population is genetically pure or hybridized. He has found species of fish in places that we had no idea about. So he's doing the work of a biologist just as sort of a volunteer.